We're broadcasting from Des Moines, Iowa, for the run-up to the Iowa caucuses. Again, Alan Keyes is my guest. He's running for president of the United States. Alan, how cool is this, really? Running for president looks great because we watch it every so often, but we don't run 20 hours a day, 7 days a week. Week after week after week, making sure you don't say anything goofy, which would be easy to do after a couple of hours, it would seem to me. Trust me, some have argued that I've done it much quicker than that. How enjoyable is this process?
Well, it has its enjoyable moments. It depends on what you enjoy, though. I mean, I enjoy having real and serious discussions about, you know, what's going on in America, what we do about these things.
Now, wait a second, and I apologize for interrupting there, but how many real conversations do you have? I'm talking in general. How many real conversations do you see in politics?
I have a lot of them because that's what I understand politics to be. We have allowed a false and corrupt understanding of politics to dominate now, where politicians are people who find out what people want to hear through focus groups and polls, refashion themselves in order to look like what people want, and then go out and basically lie. About who they are and what they're going to do. And part of the reason they stumble over themselves is they're trying to remember what lie they're supposed to be telling now because it doesn't reflect their real convictions. That's something I don't really worry about. Because to me, what politics is supposed to be is what it implies. Politeis was the Greek word for citizen. And politics is just the life or business of the citizens. We should be trying to sit down and at different levels talk. If it's a local level, a state level, you're talking about what's good for this community, what's good for my family, what's good for us. When you're involved in a presidential race, the key thing on the mind of all our people oughtn't to be what's in it for me. It ought to be what's good for America, because that's the one choice we make that is about the whole country and about what's going to happen to it. And I love talking about that. I love discussing it with people. I even love disagreeing with folks about it because there's always the chance that I'll learn or teach something that will be to the advantage of my country. And I think that's ought to be what we're about. Our politics has been cheapened and I think is in the process of being destroyed by folks who have redefined it in terms of ambition and all of this sort of stuff. And I think that that's wrong. The people of the country need to realize that this is the greatest opportunity any people has had for longer than any other people in human history has enjoyed it. And we need to live up to that.
You have a PhD in government from Harvard, former Assistant Secretary of State, used to work at the United Nations, a whole series of things. I know you've run for president, I guess it was 96, 2000. You run for other races too. Looking at the numbers, you can't win this. You can't. No, the numbers, there's no way.
That's not true. The simple fact is that the key numbers that are on my side are that the overwhelming majority of Republicans in this country agree with Alan Keyes. Down the line, they want what I represent.
Then why don't they vote for you?
Because they've never gotten the chance. Okay, the key.
Why?
I saw it in the debate the other day. Hard time getting into the debate in Iowa and Des Moines. And then once I got in, a systematic effort witnessed by everybody who watched to make sure I didn't get to participate on a fair and equal basis. Why? Because I'm saying what represents the heart of the people, their real desire. I am not part of the elite that is betraying them so that they can hold on to and build their own power. They don't want people to know that someone actually stands up for the restoration of their sovereignty, their real control of this government. A lot of the people exist in our elites now who realize that just a little bit more and the republic will be dead forever. Self-government, as it was established in this country, will be an historical memory. We will have lost this birthright. And they don't want somebody waking the people of this country up in time to stop it.
Alan, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you.